Growing up between Soweto and Sandton, 29-year-old Nthato Mokgata is an international producer, recording and visual artist. He's now made his debut as a director with a new film called Future Sounds of Mzansi, documenting SA's electronic music scene.
I've been trying to figure out what I should call you, Nthato or Spoek Mathambo. I mean, Spook's like a ghost, Mathambo are bones. Where were you when you came up with that name?
It's a story that I wrote when I was really young, when I was like in school. And then it just stuck with music and then just caught on and started making music under that name.
You've just shot your own documentary, The Future Sounds of Mzansi. Tell me a bit about it.
South Africa's got such an exciting electronic music scene. It's really recognized around the world as being like, we're the biggest consumers of electronic music in the world. And I don't think inside we understand, and we never really make the relationship between township house and dubstep and techno, that actually it's all one world of electronic music. So I wanted to travel around the country and meet different exciting producers and create those links.
Do you have any other interests besides music?
Yeah, I love being in fast vehicles.
Okay. Yeah,
so whether it's crazy planes, bungee jumping, or fast cars, just all of it.
Well, cars, I've got a surprise for you. I hope you're ready.
For sure.
Traveling abroad for live gigs, Spoek has seen many speed machines on the streets of Europe, the US, South America, and the UK. But not yet this McLaren P1 Hypercar. Together with a full McLaren team, it was brought out for the Rogue Rally by Justin Divaris.
Hey, how are you?
Good. Love to
Cheers,
see
man.
You.
Great.
Yeah. I mean, they're cars and then they're cars. This is super phenomenal, right?
Ooh. You won't see one of these too often. Only 375 made for the world.
Wow.
Best performing road and track car in the world. That's what McLaren set out to achieve. They've done it with this car.
Tell us about the design.
Well, the design's an interesting question because a lot of people think it looks so good, they must have designed it to look good. In fact, every single design feature on this car, every spoiler, every piece of carbon, it's all there for a purpose. The purpose is to give this car more downforce and better aerodynamics. The full carbon tub on this car is exactly the same as what you'd use on a Formula One car. The same technology, ultra lightweight and extreme strength, which is what the car's done here.
The bodywork feels as if it's been shrink-wrapped as tightly as possible over the car's mechanics, and the cockpit sits right at the center.
It is an art to get in and out of this car because it's super low. Look at how low that is. Compared to a normal car, it must go super fast. So talk me through the interior and the style.
Over here you have your start button, which gets the action going in the car. You've got a full touchscreen here, similar to an Apple sort of touchscreen. This integrates all your luxury features. Even though it's this hyper super performance car, you've got your navigation, your Bluetooth, your multimedia, you plug in your iPod for music. So it's got all the creature comforts, and you'll see when we go for a ride, you can drive it just as comfortably as any other car. This car is a hybrid, meaning it's got an electric engine as well, which assists for power and acceleration, and the car can be driven in full electric mode as well around town, switching off the petrol engine completely.
Wow.
It was Spoek's turn. Visibility is vital for a car like this, which is why it gives the impression of a pilot's cockpit with glass all around you. Hand-assembled by a group of 61 engineers, only once you're in it do you realize that you're practically riding the engine. You feel every one of the 349 kilometers an hour this car can do, though that speed is reserved for the track. It's been cold weather tested at minus 40 degrees Celsius in the Arctic Circle, heat tested at over 50 degrees in California, and reached an average 179 kilometers per hour in speed testing around the Nürburgring in Germany. It had spooked our guest in the best way possible.
That was so cool. The way those doors opened, it looked like you guys belonged in a movie.
It's
super cool. How was the drive for you?
It was great, it was mind-blowing. Never felt anything like that.
I mean, when you guys were driving off, and Tata's face was like...
I was freaking out,
You looked like you wanted to call your mom or something.
That was a lot of power. What kind of engine is that?
Yeah, you experienced under 3 seconds, 0 to 100. It's got a twin-turbo V8 assisted by an electric hybrid. Over 900 horsepower.
Wow.
Did I do well on the surprise?
Yeah, now I've got a surprise for you.
Fantastic.
Thanks very much.
Justin,
thanks for joining.
Fantastic.
Me.
I might buy one. Thanks yours!
I'm telling you everything.
Currently living between Jersey and his apartment in Sweden's capital city, Stockholm, Spoek invited us for lunch at his family home in Sandown. They're all passionate about music. His mother, Mandisa Mokgata, loves soul, gospel, and traditional. His father, Samuel Mokgata, is a jazz man, while his siblings got him into pop and hip-hop.
Lovely to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
Now, Mama, growing up, when did you realize that Nthato absolutely loved music and it was his passion?
He's always. We even had concerts. How old were you? 6 years old, we would call the children in the neighborhood and we'd have a concert and it would be fun and so on.
But you had a lot of like serious discussions with your father about music. When it came to music with the father, you know, be telling him the long history, you know, about this star and that and so on. Suppose that was the indication of the whole thing.
Mom's cooking must have helped.
Delicious.
Spoke's close to his mother's mom, Umakulu, and his dad's mom, Magdalene, who've both really pushed him to follow his passion for music and art. They can now see the results.
Where does your urge to create music come from?
From one side, I guess it's to communicate certain ideas. I think South Africa has a really exciting musical heritage, and I want to make sure that my generation continues that proud lineage of great music. I think that's a huge incentive for me.
Now, I'm sure all the girls in South Africa want to know, are you married?
Very happily married for about 6 years now. And my wife's name is Anna. Yeah.
Any kids?
No kids yet.
Mama, you must be so proud of what Nthato has done in his life so far.
Yes, more than anything is being grateful. When you raise a child, you just want them to be responsible adults. And whatever direction he's taken thus far, it makes his dad and I very happy. Be grateful to the Lord.
You have such an exciting future ahead. What's next for you?
This year I've been working on a project called Phantasma. It's a band, so I'm going to be releasing music under that name. So look out, we've got some really hot songs that we'll be dropping for the summertime. I've just finished the film Future Sound of Mzansi, which is going to be premiering for public to see in Johannesburg at the theatre called Bioscope in Mabone, mid-October. And yeah, hopefully just a lot more good music and good stuff.
Well, your future seems super bright and that cake looks delicious, so I think we can dig in.
Let's do it.
Added to his musical success, the icing is knowing that Spook's movie is about to be shown in UK cinemas too, and all before the man has turned 30.